So we're cutting out the puzzle. We're going to get right into the video segment. Luckily, I did keep that somewhat trimmed down, so that's not going to hurt too much in time. But yeah, we definitely need to jump in on it as we speak. So who's ready to see a bunch of MLP stuff?
Do it.
Okay, hold on. Okay, we're getting that ready here. Let's see. Of course, Blank is still drawing, so give me a moment. We will get his artistry back on track here in a moment. I just need to get up here. I hope you guys have been enjoying the insanity here as we've been trying our best to... Okay, we're going to start the video here in 3, 2, 1... Starting off, of course, with an Equestria Girls special short.
Whoa, this place is packed. Welcome, girls! Be back soon! Big test?
Yeah, how'd you know?
When you're stressed, you always order grilled cheese. Be right back! Here, Twi can help you. She's basically a genius at everything, especially math.
Oh, no, it's no big deal. I mean...
She's not the Twilight that I remembered and have horrible wet dreams about.
Hi, I want to introduce you to my friend, Rarity.
Why?
That's why.
Pinky, why are you pushing your friends on other people?
Because she can. The ship cannot die. We must keep the ship going forever.
Yeah, losers don't deserve nachos.
We're losers. We don't deserve nachos. We suck.
Wow. Yeah, we know. She's the one that beat the crap out of us.
Twilight?
No, they're just—it's just tittering. Now I want money. Can somebody tell me how you can get a sundae like that? I demand to know. I want to know if a sundae like that is humanly possible. Okay, let's move on. We are going to be shooting through these real fast, or attempting to anyway. Spike and his pieness quest, part 4.
Here we go again.
Get out here, Frenchy-ass, and take your stupid hat back to your robot country. Unless it's 10 pounds of crap in a tiny brain. You are the sorriest excuses for professors I have ever seen. And I did not join this team just to fail like you. Do not look at me. I did not ask you a question. Okay, Herr Doctor.
Don't worry, there's Spike. Took forever for Spike to finally show up.
Sorry. It's not original, but it's true. I love the sheep. I mean, look at this. Great. Boom. Jimmy. Great. Boom. Woo! The dinner.
Please help, guys. Stupid
guys.
Bloody creep.
Is anybody even paying attention to me?
Carve you a new metal cake, Owl.
Well, off to visit Molly.
Hey guys, look.
Yeah, don't ask me to explain. I have no idea. Bikes.
I don't think anyone can explain this. Not even the person who made it. They're right. Just having stupid fun.
Yep. Now behold, Pony Plane Factory, Episode 1. Now a lot of these I've been sitting on some of these videos for quite some time waiting for a good chance to finally pop them out.
Back. And back. Guys, you can go and ignore English. You can go ahead and cut the little sideshow thing because it's fucking 9:10. I need to get back on 14 for shenanigans.
Nah, it's okay. It's gotten late anyway, so it's cool.
But everybody wants, you know, other reference of what the creature actually is, and it's kept. It's called a gazelle. Gazelle did not have teeth like that.
Yep.
But these soldiers doesn't belong here! One of these kids is dead! Anyways, toodles.
See ya! I kind of feel for the animatronic here. He has no idea what's going on now.
And this is kind of the reason why all my robotic characters is kind of don't have screens, except for Ree, but that's because someone else designed her.
And now for part two.
Thank you.
by the way, looking at this animatronic, you could easily skin a dragon over it.
Probably. Okay, now here's a horrible teaser trailer that's gonna drive us all mad.
Dan! You said it would never happen! That's impossible!
And the name of this is Project Go. What is it? What does it mean? What is going on? I have no idea. Moving on.
Find a pet. I think we're just going to have to play Go to find out.
Yep. Find a pet. Kazoo cover.
It actually sounds good. Get picks and gifts.
Holy crap.
What?
Toa posted a kitchen sink sundae.
So, there is a way.
So the terrible thing that I realized during that is that background Ponyville music in the mobile game,
by the way,
is just the music from that.
Huh. And now we got DWK.
Of course he would.
Well, guess who's back? Back again. Now, those of you who've been around here for a while know how much I love Chrysalis and...
Yes, I know. We have been planning this for quite some time.
What's going on here?
Which means you will be able to use them too.
Hey, Chrissy Doodle Dandy. Who are you talking to there?
Why copies, Rarity? Because Princess Twilight and her friends control the elements of harmony.
Oh, you're hanging up pictures of ponies and talking to them like they're actually there. Well, all I can say is welcome to the club. There's free drinks and group weeping sessions every Friday. Anyways, you might be able to surmise Buggy Boo's been going through a rough patch ever since she got Glim Glammed. She's been living out in the woods for God knows how many months and has reached that critical intersection of isolation, misanthropy, and psychological instability at which one of three things is bound to happen. To a person.
The first and most obvious is
suicide, which for most of us is the best solution, because as you know, when we die, we go to Equestria, I promise. The problem is Chrissy's already there, and
calm
it doesn't
down. He's
to
making
be working
fun.
Out,
Don't
so that's
it.
A no-go. The second option is taking responsibility for your fuck-ups, accepting the fact that in all likelihood, the majority of your misfortune is the result of your own poor character and laziness, and then trying to become a better person, but fuck that. So the third option is this.
Thank you, Applejack. Thank you, Applejack. Thank you. Thank you.
Tulpas. She's made main six tulpas. Not only that, Chrissy's concocted some sort of unholy magic-fueled alchemy that can turn her imaginary friends into bootleg waifus. And she's like, all right, you dumb horse, listen up. We're gonna find the elements of harmony and use their power to put you bitches into mass production. Seeing as Equestria's main export is waifus, flooding the market with cheap knockoffs will destabilize its entire economy, causing civil unrest, which I will exploit by disguising myself as a pretty pony politician and pandering to the disenfranchised masses. I'll whip them into a fervor, lead a rebellion, topple the Equestrian government, and seize power. Then I can take away Starlight Glimmer's friends and ruin her life just like she did to me. Why don't we just kill her? No, listen, that's not how evil plots work. There's gotta be like machinations and subterfuge and shit, and then a big reveal where you're like, haha, remember me? And they're like, no! And then you rule the world and get all the hugs. Servants. I meant servants. Power and servants. Gay. I say we break her spine and make her watch while we kill her friends.
What is wrong with you guys?
Bitch, you tell me.
Anyway, while Chrissy's doing whatever I just said, Twiggles, Glimmy, and the crew are traveling into the woods to find an excuse to be in the woods. And Twiggy's like, I made it a schedule for the thing we're doing. But Dashy's all, schedules? I don't like those.
I don't like loud noises.
I do. Holy fuck.
I like stuff, but I didn't bring it.
I don't like stuff, but I did. Come on, Starlight. Now it's your turn.
Can't we just assume everyone's watched the show? Why do you always have to be such a contrarian pain in the cunt, Starlight?
Made you do it for me.
Whoa, well played.
I'm next level, bro.
I like how in this episode, Glimmer finally feels like a legitimate part of the crew.
All the ambivalence towards her is gone and she's not constantly spouting horse remorse. She's just another part of this jambalaya of neurosis that is the main cast. So, meanwhile, Chrissy's realizing that all of her tulpa golems are shitty people, and she's like, hey, stop being a bunch of pathetic assholes. Takes one to make one.
God damn it, why don't you respect me?
Because we're just parts of you, and you hate yourself?
I don't hate myself, I hate Starlight Glimmer.
Let me see, we got Fluttershy, Applejack, Rarity, Rainbow Dash, Pinkie Pie, and me. Technically, you're the Starlight Glimmer of the group. You know what? I hate you. Exactly.
Fantastic. Fantastic. First, now Fluttershy lost the world behind us.
Twilight, stop whining. Holy shit, everybody's getting lost and mixed up, and you're like, huh, my retreat is off to a great start.
Shut the fuck up. If you're gonna bitch, at least make it entertaining like Rarity does. Nobody wants to hear you passive-aggressively pissing and moaning under your breath.
It's just Jesus funny watching all this.
Horses, man. You know, it's been so many years, and I've spent so many hours with these characters that they just feel like family members at this point, and every time I watch an episode, I end up arguing with at least one of them. Then again, I can't really say shit. Imagine what it's like to be Twilight Sparkle, and I don't mean like, ooh, I'm a pretty pony, that's my fetish, you fucking degenerates. I mean, think about what it means to live her life. Just a minute ago, you were this snippy, antisocial nerd girl working your way through Celestia's pony college, humping books from morning till dawn, and now, only a few years later, you are your entire nation's only competent ruler, as well as the leader of its primary defense force, which is comprised of this group of chicks who, despite being like
family to you are undeniably a bunch of crazy cunts. At least once a year, for going on a decade now, the world has nearly ended, often putting said friends in mortal danger and leaving it solely to you to rescue them and everyone else. Basically, there was one time it didn't all fall on your shoulders and you spent that day in a bucket full of changeling jizz. Now it's the current year, and not only do you have two personal proteges to keep track of, you're running an entire school that might start a war if you fuck it up. You have to be a ruler, a soldier, a teacher, and a role model all at the same time while staying sane enough to maintain these interpersonal relationships that have given your life meaning. So yeah, never mind, I'm full of shit. Twiggy, if you want to complain, you're entitled to it more than literally anyone else in the world. Anyway, got off topic there. So, Chrissy finally gets her shit together and finds the elements, and as usual, realizes just a moment too late that she fucked up. See, as we all know, these fucking things exist to protect Equestria, and nothing is more paramount to its security and prosperity than producing the choicest, highest quality cutie pies. So of course the elements are imbued with waifu quality control magic. As soon as the bootlegs get within range, they get turned into magic goo, and then wood comes out. Usually you get the wood first and then the magic goo comes out, but whatever, suspension of disbelief. Also, who fucking cares that they changed it from the leaked version? Stop getting mad about everything. Yeah, you guys, I'm talking to you. Stop getting mad about every fucking thing. Just enjoy the show for once. Jesus fucking Christ. So, the main seven get to their campsite and it's all fucked up, but they're just like, nah, that sucks, but whatevs. And that's what this all amounted to. Chrissy, congratulations, you've managed to moderately inconvenience your mortal enemy. You know, Bugaboo's always been my favorite villain in the show, but it was mostly because she had an awesome design and a very sexy voice. My dick has a lot of say in my opinions. But now, taken together with all her past appearances, this episode makes something very plain. Chrysalis is a fucking loser, and I love it. She's bitter, lonely, has no self-awareness, fucks up everything she tries to do, and then blames it on everyone else. Chrissy, I love you, but you are like the villainy equivalent of an incel. God fucking help you, dude. God fucking help you.
An incel?
No, listen, that's not how evil plots work. There's gotta be like machinations and subterfuge and shit, and then a big reveal where you're like, ha ha, remember me? And then they go like, oh no! And then you...
Yeah, had fun with that line.
Is he friend or is he foe?
Seems like only yesterday I was saving this place.
Oh boy, this is fun.
Every pony is really starting to regret letting Spike believe this.
You get to smile and wave.
Actually,
like a princess.
To be fair, he was the one, because he stole it, and... Like not a
princess. Yeah, okay.
Two types of people in the world.
Okay, incel, definition. A.K.A. involuntarily celibate. A person, usually male, who has a horrible personality, treats women like sexual objects, thinks his lack of a sex life comes from being ugly, when it's really just his blatant sexism and terrible attitude. Incels have little to no self-awareness. Even when they see other ugly men with girlfriends, they consider these men to be tricksters who have somehow beat the system and can get women despite being cursed with unattractiveness. In other words, they're respectful to women, and women are attracted to their personalities, but incels can't comprehend such a phenomenon. They believe that women owe them sex, and many or more extreme incels like to spend time in incel communities on the internet, coming up with ways to make women have sex with them, often involving genocide of people of color, genocide of chads, men who have sex, taking rights away from women, raping them, having sex with women's bodies, and ugh. I don't want to get political,
but... You can stop now.
I think I have no choice but to stop. But we get the idea, right?
Yeah, we got the idea a couple sentences back, I think.
Yeah.
Old news. T-Rex breath only condensates while the hood is up, because that's how he hides his vape pen. Also, his beard.
Vaguely creepy, that's probably a better description than the
once his face is visible, it does.
Lancing tirade I just did.
Close-up shot, because otherwise we'd see T-Rex talking while doing this. Princess Celestia sleeps in her royal garb. Meanwhile, Princess Luna sleeps outside Celestia's door. Luna's mane gets stuck in the door.
This was not a dream, but a vision.
Visions are canon, and this raises a lot of questions, and a lot of plot convenience.
even befriending a young unicorn wizard.
Yes, because Star Swirl looks so young here.
And Tirek was sent to Tartarus for his crimes.
Why do I have what on hotkey?
Conspiracy to take over Equestria. He hadn't actually done anything yet, and for that, his punishment was literally being sent to hell. Nice justice system you have there, Celestia. The ancient text, which laid the foundation for the show, is a picture book. Also, this is clearly supposed to be the same book the show opens on, but there are a few differences, the least of which definitely isn't the fact it's facing the wrong way. Canterlot may or may not be missing, depending on how nitpicky you want to get, but one sin that's undeniable is the return of this green squiggly line. Green squiggly line.
What if what's locked inside is something that could help her prove her royal worth?
That's right, kids. If you don't buy the new playset that's locked inside this chest, you're letting down Twilight Sparkle. Blythe Scooter from Littlest Pet Shop is the greatest crossover since Marvel's Infinity War. Discord leaves notes in the script to help things move along.
We're still on for tea later, aren't we, Fluttershy?
I wouldn't miss it.
For a Klondike bar.
I think the reformed Discord is more obnoxious than the before he was reformed Discord.
Yeah, you know, I much prefer the Discord who enslaved and tormented all of Equestria for 1,000 years. Discord talks to an old friend about his newfound pony obsession. The only deviation from reality here is that the old friend doesn't run in the opposite direction. Discord is swayed to the dark side a little too easily. It would make more sense if we saw him slowly change sides, or if we saw him display some more hesitation about ponies prior to this. But instead, he's depicted as a gullible fool, changing sides quicker than, well, any villain in Equestria Girls.
How could I forget? He was one of the hardest things I ever had to do.
Clip show alert! Run for cover! Take shelter in your nearest rerun!
But maybe there's something special about those objects that could lead us to the location of the keys. I know it sounds crazy.
Finding deep meaning in random things is literally the definition of crazy.
There must be a connection.
Come on, Twilight. Surely some pony as book smart as you with no correlation does not imply causation. Boneless turns into a key right away, but these items don't.
I haven't. If I had, I would have written about it in the journal.
Maybe it's the journal then. It's not, but they don't know that. If this episode played out realistically, they'd be throwing things at the box all day to see what sticks.
We must rid ourselves of our magic before Tirek has the chance to steal it from us.
Behold, logic almost as sound as Equestria's justice system. To be continued.
As in Discord, Discord?
Yes. There must be something in this library that can help me figure out how to open it. The answer's in one of these books. I just know it. Perfect.
Alright. Moving on. Twilight Sparkle and Nelson's Desposito 2. Or however long we can survive this.
Oh no.
Listen to me!
I never claim to be perfect. My mistakes are all written.
Actually, this isn't a bad beat
None
to go with it.
Claim to be perfect, and it's sad if that's what
that's
you
the
all
disturbing
think.
Thing about this.
Our flaws have to make us special. They bond us and keep us strong. Our flaws are what brought us together. So stop acting like something.
Still like what's brought about.
Well, how's that for, disturbingly good?
None of us ever claimed to be perfect. Without our flaws, there wouldn't be any friendship lessons to learn. Without our flaws, there probably wouldn't be any friendships at all.
Why don't the Ponyville background characters keep wearing these shirts and hats?
Thank you for enrolling at
You're asking the wrong question. Now watch this.
The best education possible. Could you sign these enrollment papers, please?
Wait! I didn't know there'd be a test on the first day. I haven't even had time to study.
No, Sonana. All we have to do is write our names on these papers
a little bit
so
dumb.
They know that we're students here.
But still dumb.
Okay. Do you mind? Don't look. Finished.
It'll have to do.
Hey, awesome, Brony. We're actually getting close to the end here. I think this is the last one before our closing video.
Rainbow Dash sure is acting uppity over all her newfound heroism.
Agreed. Girls, we need to do something.
Why don't you all go talk to her about how you feel? Be direct about your concerns and work it out.
Or, we passive-aggressively make up a new superhero character and use it to crush Dash's spirit and resolve, all behind her back.
Friendship is magic!
I need a cup of cider right now to deal with this bullshit.
I think you need more than just a cup of cider.
Oh, no, got one more.
Dear Princess Celestia, I have received your paper on the illusion of vice and will be more than happy to report my thoughts and insight on the matter. As Aristotle once said, I know of one evil, ignorant, and one good knowledge. It was interesting how many given involved the of fiction and failing from sheer ignorance despite having a greater strength.
Alright, now we are at the final closeout. So, you know what that means, everybody. It's time to say our goodnights. And, to be a little quicker, better than usual. Yay, music! Alright, so here's our closing music. Let's get our final shoutouts from those who remain. Starting off with Coldust.
Yes. I don't know.
Maybe he's not muted.
He's not muted. He's talking right now.
Shouts out to Toa not being able to hear me.
Can't hear him. Yep.
Shout out to Popsicles because I've been eating a lot of Popsicles. Yes.
Speaking
it's
with
really
that,
hot.
And I enjoy them.
Also, shout outs to me next week if I actually manage to get the show going. And if I don't, the -12 shout outs to Gryffindor.
All right, since Toa's eager to jump
also
in.
Also, shout-out to...
Go ahead.
Shout-out.
Shout-out to shout-outs.
I actually didn't... yes. Shout-outs to shout-outs. Yes. CMC, we need to, like, come up with a planning time. Also, Creature, if you're listening. Creature.
Thing.
You too.
All right, let's go to Toa then. Toa, final shout-out, since you're so eager to shout-out.
Shout-out to all the lovely people that have come and gone. Shouts out to our Twitch audience of Angel Fay Friend, Commander Root, La Fusion, Sub Zero TD, Tech Stallion, The Only Tech Man, and me at the end, and CMC for being our cool mod.
Alright. Speaking of which, CMC, final shout out.
Fires, explosion. Eloy, Roan, kitty cat that just ran away. Goodbye, kitty cat. And venison jerky.
Alright. Tech Stallion, final shout out.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick. Okay, thank you all for joining us for another episode of the Brony Show. Tune in next week for yet another fun-filled show. Will we go back to the puzzle, or will we put it to the side for a couple weeks just to come back to it later and forget where all our pieces are? Only time will tell. But along with that, stay tuned for the Coffeehouse After Party. We'll have a little bit of fun shenanigans before we call it a night. Along with that, Wednesdays, you have Zeta Prime Time. 1 hour early at 6:30 Mountain, which is 8:30 Eastern. If you want to catch up, wait. Actually, do you know if he's doing it? Because that's new. That's on Independence Day.
I don't know if he's doing anything quite yet.
Okay, Dino Winchester
is. We're not quite sure if we're doing anything because of that. Mm.
You know what? If Wednesday happens, keep an eye out. Otherwise, enjoy your holiday, I guess. Is that about the crunch of it, I guess?
Yeah.
All right, well, we'll go with that. All right, but Friday, we have Gaming Meltdown. Oh, no, we don't. That's Saturday. Friday, we will hopefully have more RPG Rhone Session goodness for you all to enjoy on stream. Saturday, we have Gaming Meltdown with Creature. Be sure to check that out. Sunday, Circuits Let's Play, of course, with yours truly. And of course, and hopefully the Flagstop will be able to get out of its pudding coated covers and enjoy another show 1 hour early next week.
Yeah, hopefully. I'd really like to get that going again.
I would like to see it going too. You guys are awesome. I mean, you can do it.
We try.
Alright. Then thank you all to Crazy Matt Captain for keeping an eye on the chat. Thank you to Awesome Brony, Clouded Rock Raider 63, Cool Dude 13233, Sarcasm, Dimension, DM12, Everfan, Fantastic Frank, Class 4, Creature, Mike Nice, Relay Surf, Sonic 4421, Sub Zero DD, Tech Man, Tech Sally, Tolkoi, Vaguely Creepy, and yay, Archivers!
He forgot to breathe.
Can I give a negative, like, 27 shout out to the heat? Because I'm getting tired of it being so goddamn hot.
Yeah, I'm getting tired of having the AC on because it dries out the air, and my sinuses are just not liking that.
I will give a nigga shout out too, but not because it's hot right now. Actually, it's rather mild, but it's going to get ridiculous later. So I'm not too thrilled about that this week. So shout outs to sucky hair, air, sucky heat, sucky hair and heat. Oh, God. Okay, closing out. Beans, PMV, enjoy it. Good night, everybody. We'll be right back. And that's it. Have a good night, everybody.